Web and Create.
You have no idea.
Every writer writes inspiration. And I found mine.
Seven years ago, I thought I would never write again. And then you walked through the door, and my whole world changed.
You were right.
You said I had no idea. But now I know it.
Mr. Castle's offered to assist with the investigation.
Really?
Apparently, you have a fan.
A fan, sir?
Rick Castle. Seems he's found the main character for his next set of novels, a tough but savvy female detective.
I'm flattered.
Don't be. He says he has to do research.
How long, sir?
I'm so damn.
Looks like I have a fan.
Yeah, a really deranged fan.
Deranged to me.
What?
In the library of Catherine Beckett.
I got you an advance copy. I even signed it to you. That's your fan.
Thanks. That's actually sweet.
It's nice to meet you, Detective Beckett.
You really knew how big a fan you really are.
You never told me how his novels got you through your mother's death.
Why are you here?
I'm here for the story.
The story.
Something happened. Not to you. It was somebody you cared about. It was someone you loved. And you probably could have lived with that, but the person responsible was never called.
Don't think you know.
The point is, there's always a story. You just have to find it.
It was my mother. She had been stabbed. They attributed it to gang violence. They couldn't fit outside the box. So they just tried to package it up nicely. And the killer was never caught.
Why do you wear the watch?
This is for the life that I saved. And this is for the life that I lost. I guess your Nikki Heat has a backstory now, Castle.
I did kind of like the hooker by day, cop by night thing. But, I guess that's a heavy emotional angle could work too.
Female detective of yours, exactly how much will she be based on me?
She's gonna be really smart. Very savvy. Haunting good looks. Really good at her job.
This isn't a speech, it's not a platitude, it's a promise. I am going to do everything in my power to make sure that they pay for what they did.
Most people come up against a wall. They give up. Not you. You don't let go. You don't back down. That's what makes you extraordinary.
It's about your mother's case. Have you ever thought about reopening it?
What are you doing?
Nothing. I just thought it would work together.
No.
I have resources.
Castle, you touch my mom's case, and you and I are done. Do you understand?
You have to tell her. You have information that could lead to her mother's killer.
She said if I open the file, that would be through.
It doesn't matter. She has to know.
It's about your mother. It's because you're afraid, isn't it? You're afraid that if you look into your mother's death, that you will go back down that rabbit hole and lose yourselves again. But it's different this time. You won't have to do it alone. We can do it together.
What if I don't want to know? Did you ever think of that?
I'm sorry. What I did was wrong. I violated your trust. I opened old wounds, and I did not respect your wishes. And if we're not going to see each other again, then you deserve to know. I'm very, very sorry.
See you tomorrow.
Novelist is my job to produce this.
when were you going to tell me about the other book? Did it ever occur to you to talk to me first?
It would be a very big opportunity for me.
Wait a minute, a certain British secret agent, are you?
They actually offered to me. They may not be.
Yeah, but if they do?
I don't know that I'm ready to walk away from Nikki Heat.
Who, the one on the page? The one standing over there?
The one on the page.
Hey, I was just, the dedication. Wow, thank you.
I meant it. You are extraordinary.
Good luck on your new book.
Thanks. You take care of yourselves.
Would I be interested in doing three more Nikki Heat?
Three books? That would take forever.
Are you coming or what?
Detective Mechanic, there is no doubt in my mind that Jack Cooney was killed by the same man who murdered your mother.
Kate!
Hey.
I will do anything that you need, including nothing, if that's what you want.
What I want is to find my mother's killer.
Do you want to catch her killer? The price is 100 grand.
What if I let her down? I can't just shoot that kind of money.
You can't. I can.
Put a round in this man's liver, and he will die slowly. An inconsiderable pain.
She was just another job.
She was my mother, who hired you to kill her.
Forget it. He'll never touch her.
Guys like Wolf, they come in, they upset the apple cart. Of course, he makes you feel alive, but oh, why not? Eventually, you know he's just gonna let you down.
Did she just flip her hair?
So why risk it?
Because the heart wants what the heart wants.
Go home and get some sleep.
Sir, I don't have a home.
Yes, you do. It's a secure building with an extra bedroom with people who care about you.
Thank you, Castle, but I couldn't.
You can and you will.
Who cares about you, Kate? You may not see it. You may not be ready to, but he does.
My father's watch. Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm sure after all this years, you're a little sorry you let me follow you around.
Not this. All the other annoying things I used to do, but not this. What about you? Are you sorry that you ever wrote Heatwave?
The way I look at it now, if it wasn't for Nikki Heat, this guy would have just gone on killing because he wouldn't have met anyone smart enough to catch him.
Ocean View, from my patio.
You should come.
Yeah. No. You know, some of us have to work for a living.
Beach house. Thought you were working this weekend.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Castle. I should have just told you. I just didn't want things to be awkward between us now that Tom and I are together.
Dude, that makes what I was going to say he's here.
I thought this would be our last case.
So, Castle's last case, huh?
Yeah, well, it's not like he's leaving forever.
Why do you think he's been following around all this time?
What, research?
The guy's done enough research to write 50 books.
Whatever the reason is, pretty sure it doesn't include watching TV with another guy.
Hey.
Hey.
It's sad a man had to die because all the people involved were too scared to say what they really felt.
What?
I think...
Okay.
I think that this is what I'm looking for right now.
What is it you're looking for, Kate?
I know that I'm not the easiest person to get to know. And I don't always let on what's on my mind. But this past year working with you, I've had a really good time.
Yeah, me too. It's been really, really good.
Fall?
See you in the fall.
You've been informed of your rights, Mr. Castle.
Really? You're not even going to ask me how my son was? You look good.
You look good, too. Go home. Go back to your Hamptons, your ex-wife, your book parties. Okay, I've got work to do.
What did I do? A sign.
A sign?
A sign. A sign from the universe telling us we need to solve this case together. You don't want to let the universe down, do you? I missed you too.
You're not going to go away no matter what I do, are you?
I respect the universe.
I know who the killer is.
So, see you tomorrow. Until tomorrow, Detective.
You can't just say night.
I'm a writer. Night is boring. Until tomorrow is more hopeful.
See you tomorrow.
You will meet an Alexander.
My given name is Richard Alexander Rogers.
And he will be extremely important to you.
What a coincidence.
At some future date, he may save your life.
You gotta make a statement. It's gotta be big.
Actually, most girls prefer something a little more intimate.
So he's just supposed to be boring and ask,
will you marry me? I don't believe in much, but I believe in us. And no matter the obstacles, no matter how hard you try, you'll never get rid of me. I love you.
Would you be willing to break her out of prison?
Don't worry, Castle. I get you out.
Because that, my boy, is true love.
You coming? I'm so glad that you're okay. It's not your fight.
The hell it isn't. I don't hang around you just to annoy you. If that's all this was, I would have quit a long time ago.
Well, then why do you keep coming back, Rick?
Like it or not, I'm your plucky sidekick.
Plucky sidekick always gets killed.
Partner, then.
Okay.
I saw the blood on your shirt. I thought you'd been shot.
You have written 22 novels before you met her, and you didn't need to spend every day in the police station in order to finish them.
It's not about the books anymore.
Chuck Norris. How's the hand?
Excruciating.
took you. Rub my back in there.
Always. I know you would do it if you won the lottery. You would use the money to honor your mother's legacies. The dean of your mom's old law school. You talked about starting a scholarship in Joanna Beckett's name. And with your blessing, I would like to host a fundraiser to fund it.
You just can't stay out of my personal life, can you? Thank you. It's really sweet. Richard Castle believes in you, and I believe in him.
I was hoping you'd still be here.
I was just about to call you. I think I know who the killer is.
I'm sure if you could use a drink, right about now.
Bye.
Valentine's Day.
We've got a couple of hours. Castle. I wish that I had someone who would be there for me and I could be there for him. Thank you for being there. We could just dive into it together.
Always.
So no, I got no clue what we are. I know I don't want to see you throw your life away.
Yeah, well, last time I checked, it was my life, not your personal jungle gym.
You know what? This isn't about your mother's case anymore. This is about you needing a place to hide. Because you've been chasing this thing so long, you're afraid to find out who you are without
me. You don't know me, Castle. You think you do, but you don't.
So you crawled inside your mother's murder and didn't come out. I know you hide there. Same way you hide these new relationships with men. You don't love them. You could be happy, Kate. You deserve to be happy. But you're afraid.
You know what we are, Cassie? We are over.
If anything happens to her,
I'm sorry. someone who's better than halfway through the movie. Don't waste another minute of it.
Captain Montgomery once said to me that for us there is no victory. There are only battles. And in the end, the best you can hope for is to find a place to make your stand. And if you're very lucky, you find someone willing to stand with you.
Thank you.
For what?
for not pushing, giving me the space to get through this.
Always. I'm kind of envy.
Well, who knows, Castle? Maybe third time's a charm.
They both want to be together, but neither of them wants to admit to it.
Why do people do that to themselves?
Maybe they just don't see it.
How could they not? It's so obvious.
When you get cute, when you get angry. But not when you get angry with me.
What did little Kate Beckett want to be when she grew up?
I was on my way to becoming the first female Chief Justice.
When he's gone, the first thing she'll do is give her a castle.
She's hoping it's him. Because if he's gone, I'm gone.
Castle, you can't make this one about you.
What am I supposed to do, Rick? I can't just stop being a cop just because it's inconvenient.
No. Just. You can wait.
You don't think I don't know what's at stake here? Do you think I actually want to do this?
Then don't do it.
I don't have a choice.
You're sure this isn't about Sophia?
No, why would it be?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe because I based a character on her.
I might have been a little bit taken aback to find out that you had researched with someone else.
It was never the way it is with you and me. Besides, Nicky Heat is a far more complex and nuanced character.
Has there been others?
Women?
Muses.
No. Why?
I just wanted to see how big the club was, that's all.
There is no club. And second, we're off the case, if you recall.
You are off the case.
If you're stupid enough to keep going, I'm stupid enough to go with you. We're all on the same team here.
No, you're on her team. Because the way you look at her, you're sure as hell not on mine.
I found something.
Well, shouldn't you tell Sophia about it?
She isn't my partner. You are.
Clara started off as Sophia, but she ended up being more like you. Smart, fierce, kind. I think that's one of the reasons I was drawn to you. As a muse.
I've been thinking about the victims and all the opportunities they'll never have. And I don't want that to happen.
It makes you think about all those things in your own life that you don't want to put off anymore.
I really thought we could have a future together. I was willing to wait.
I was shot in the chest, and I remember every second of it.
All this time, you remembered.
She didn't say anything.
She was embarrassed. She didn't feel the same way.
Was Castle here?
Yeah, earlier. But he said he had to go, so there was somewhere he needed to be.
Now that the case is done, what did you want to talk about?
Something happened.
Nothing important, anyway.
Something changed.
Right.
It's been weird between us lately.
Good night. He's different. It's like he's pulling away. Is everything okay?
Little better.
You know she's just a passing thing.
Do I? Has been divorced twice and he's still chasing bimbos. Maybe that's just who he is.
4 dates in 3 days. You like her?
Yeah. What?
She doesn't seem like your type.
Well, she's fun and uncomplicated. I think that's what my life needs right now.
Look, maybe it's the wrong time. Or maybe he's even the wrong guy, but if he is, how long are you gonna wait to find out? The guy is crazy about you, and despite your little act, you're crazy about him.
I thought that the two of us were actually getting closer together, and now he's running around with another cop.
Why he's acting like this? I mean, what did I do?
Castle said that he loved
him. I wasn't ready to hear that then.
What do you
then?
Think he's telling you with his behavior?
That maybe he's not there anymore, that maybe he's not ready? If I waited too long?
You did this for me. You weren't waiting.
This time you had my back.
No problem, Castle. It's what partners are supposed to do.
When a life-altering moment occurs, people remember.
Well, maybe it's too big to deal with. Maybe he can't face it just yet.
Do you think he ever will be?
Hopefully. Do you feel safe?
He's going to need therapy.
It helps.
I didn't know you were seeing a therapist.
Yeah, well, I didn't want to make any excuses. I think I'm almost where I want to be now. In a place where I can finally accept everything that happened that day. Everything. And that wall that I was telling you about, I think it's coming down.
Well, I'd like to be there when it does.
Yeah, I'd like you to be there too. Tomorrow?
I will be distracting myself with a double feature of The Killer and Hardcore. Wanna join me, Richard?
Actually, I'd love to. You coming, Castle?
Yeah.
Things are finally getting better for him. For us. She's just coming out of her shell about this. Montgomery's friend was very clear. She starts poking around her mother's murder. They'll come after her again. Can't let that happen. I'm not in this alone. I'm here.
I know. Are you Lawrence?
I was just trying to keep you safe.
By lying to me about the most important thing in my life? How the hell could you do this?
Because I love you.
Listen to you? Why should I listen to you? How am I even supposed to trust anything that you say?
Because of everything we've been through together. 4 years, I've been right here. 4 years just waiting for you to open your eyes to see them right here.
And I'm more than a partner. Every morning I bring you a cup of coffee just so I can see a smile on your face, because I think you are the most remarkable, maddening, challenging, frustrating person I've ever met.
Castle, you cut a deal for my life. My life. Mine. You don't get to decide. Castle!
Throw it away if you want, but I'm not gonna stick around and watch you.
Castle!
I'm done.
There's a universal truth we all have to face.
I resign.
Everything eventually ends. Endings are inevitable. You close the book. You say goodbye. We're moving on. There are some people who are so much a part of us, they'll be with us no matter what. They are our solid ground, our North Star. The small, clear voices in our hearts that will be with us.
Becca, what do you want?
You. Always.
I'll never be safe.
Kay, tell me you didn't.
We reached an understanding.
I'll get justice for her. Just not today.
But here's the thing about a secret workplace, Roman. In the beginning, you're on a high. Every stolen moment feels like a shot of adrenaline straight to the heart.
Act normal. And when we're in public, you're single and I'm single. Got it?
Get butterflies on your way into work. It's exciting and dangerous, and the sex is amazing.
And then what?
And then it imploded.
Maybe people find out, and maybe we'll implode, or maybe we'll continue to be amazing. The point is, we don't have the answers. We just have to live with the questions and find our way.
Thank you.
Believing in me.
make sense on paper. We don't live our lives on paper.
I thought I lost you.
Never, never.
I know how much the holidays mean to you, and I know that you love Christmas, but I can't make it tomorrow. I'm gonna have to work. Look, I'm sorry. I know that you're disappointed.
No, it's not your fault. I know. It's okay. You volunteered here to take Eldon's shift.
If you aren't ready, why not just tell me?
Christmas means something different to me than it does to you.
It's Christmas. I mean, how can it be different?
Castle, every winter, as soon as that chill rolls in, I'm right back there in that alley. January 9th, we still haven't taken our Christmas decorations down. And by the time my dad and I did, it was like we were putting Christmas away forever.
I didn't know.
That's why, ever since I became a rookie, I have taken the Christmas shift. And that is my tradition. And that is important to me. It's as important as your tradition is to you.
I understand.
Whether there's a Santa Claus or not, that's not why I love Christmas. I love that feeling. It's sensible.
On the shortest, darkest days of the year, people won't be able to celebrate the light. With a toy on plus, who Christmas doesn't love
presents? I just want you here tonight, holding on to me so tight.
Girl, what can I do? Merry Christmas.
Know that all I want
for Christmas is you. I don't want a lot for Christmas.
I was coming to see you.
No,
what about your show?
I got Karpowski to cover. What about your family tradition?
I just want you for my own, more than you could ever know. Make my wish come true, you know that all I want
for Christmas is you.
It's perfect. Kate will see.
I don't care. Here's a decaf. Turn around.
Thank you. Back to my boarding school days, my first semester there, I was in danger of fucking up. I needed an A on my term paper.
So you wrote the paper on that car company?
Someone else did. And I paid him $250.
I don't understand why that would change how I see you.
Because it changed how I saw myself. It was the first time I was celebrated for anything, and it was a fraud. I was a fraud. That's what I've learned, how to write. I wrote and wrote, trying to be as great as everyone thought I was.
You're right, Castle. It does change how I see you. It makes me like you just a little bit more. You with Kate? That's your number one. When did you write this?
Well, like 3 years ago. Wow. Happy birthday to me. That's my present. I can't wait to unwrap it.
Later. Right now, let's just forget about the murder. Go to dinner. Celebrate your life. And celebrate some more. What were you doing looking out the window anyway?
I was bored.
So you saw what you wanted to see? Alright, I'm gonna make a soup. I'm gonna get you to bed.
Where are you going?
Castle, I made plans for you. I dressed up for you, and I'm not gonna let you ruin this night.
So what are you gonna do?
I am going to go over there, and then you and I are going to dinner and never talking about this again.
No, don't do it. It's too dangerous.
Becky, no! No!
Jackie, where are you?
Happy birthday!
You let me think I was crazy? You let me think you were gonna die?
Without a doubt.
The greatest birthday gift of my life!
Well, I figured the trickiest part would be fooling you and a straight face.
What you did for me, nobody's ever done that for me before. That was epic. But you do know that now I will have to get you back.
Oh, really? And you think that you can top that?
Oh, just you wait and see. You did.
You believe that, don't you?
It's true.
I think I'm standing on a bomb.
We don't know that you're standing on a bomb. It could be nothing.
Well, you're right.
I'm right.
No, if I have to be stuck, not standing on a bomb, then I'm glad I'm stuck with you.
You've stepped on a sensor plate wired to a detonator.
Castle, please, there is no reason to put yourself in danger. There's nothing that you can do here.
Nothing? Excuse me, who's going to be your bomb buddy?
Castle, I'm going to be fine. I feel fine.
That would be great if you were a reliable judge of your own feelings, which clearly you're not.
Forget it. I'm not going down that path. You can just go now.
Fine, I'll leave. If you admit to me, you had feelings for me when we first met.
Fine. I did have feelings for you when we first met. I couldn't stand you.
If you couldn't stand me when we first met, tell me this. Why couldn't you keep your hands off me?
Oh, so you're being harassed? Is that it?
You're very lucky, a less understanding man would press charges with all the inappropriate things you've said to me.
Well, like you've never been inappropriate.
Me? I've never been anything but a perfect gentleman.
Oh, yeah. Keep telling yourself that, Castle. Castle, listen to me.
I'm not leaving.
Look, I know, but depending on what happens, there's something that I need you to do. Just promise me to do it.
Yeah, but you don't need to be thinking like this.
I'm trying to be realistic, Castle. I've been standing here for hours, and I'm feeling the fatigue set in.
Don't think about it. It's mind over body. You can convince yourself of almost anything. Much like you convinced yourself you weren't crazy about me.
You were into me.
Me into you?
Yeah.
Me into you? No. Definitely not.
Okay, fine. Then why were you following me around? And don't say that it was research, because no one believed that for a second.
Because I was having so much fun playing cop.
That's not why you're following me around.
It is, too. And anything else you come up with is strictly a product of your imagination.
Well, it's obvious that you and I are not going to resolve this. I can tell when you're lying, Castle. You knew that. Like when you said that you were following me just to play cop. And what did he actually say?
There's a time on the bomb. Hey, we will get you out of this.
And what makes you so sure?
We've been in bad situations before.
Yeah, there is something about us that seems to draw in trouble.
That is the situation we get, we always find a way out.
Okay, fine. So how are we going to find our way out of this one?
I keep thinking this answer is in Fozzie's story.
Why does his story matter?
Story always matters. That's actually why we make such a great team. You find the evidence. Evidence helps me build a story. The story points us to the solution. See? The story. It's our secret ingredient.
It's time to say goodbye.
I'm not leaving.
Please, Castle, please don't make this any harder for us to me.
I wish I could.
secure in our relationship. So many things.
No, there's no regret. All in all, I think we've had a great run. You should go.
Rick.
I didn't come here to die. I came here to defuse the bomb. There's still a chance.
Yes, a 1 in 100,000 chance.
Right? Well, there's still a chance. I'm not giving up.
Well, there's barely a minute left. You've got to go.
Come on, yeah. These are the letters. They're calling me.
Mysterious.
You know, Kessel, it wasn't too long ago when me wearing a sexy outfit would get an immediate response from you.
What are you saying, that I'm taking you for granted?
I don't know, Kessel, are you? What is this?
That's just me not taking you for granted.
Wait a minute, is this you being jealous?
Yes. The guy won a MacArthur Genius Award. You know what they give those awards to? Geniuses. So yes, when you're in a room with him alone, I'm a little jealous. He's so impressive.
But he's not you.
You're right. I've been taking you for granted. But no longer. Tonight, it's all about me giving you a romantic full-body massage. Bigger things for you.
Who says I want bigger things?
Practically everything about you screams it. There's a job opening in D.C.
If I get that job, then you're gonna have to. Yeah.
You fly to D.C. yesterday?
I was invited down for an interview.
I'm sorry. You interviewed for another job in another city. And you didn't tell me?
I didn't tell you about it because it was just an interview and I knew that you would be upset.
Damn right, I'm upset.
Yes, I just wanted to see what was out there. What's wrong with that?
What's wrong with it is that you hid it from me. In fact, you lied about it. I wouldn't do that to you.
Yes, please don't do this. Please don't make this about us.
I'm sorry, tell me how this is about us. You get this job, you move to D.C., I'll never see you. That's pretty much the end of our relationship, isn't it?
You don't know that. And I probably won't even get the job.
That's not the point. The point is... You knew what this could mean, and it didn't occur to you to include me. Or worse, it did occur to you. And you chose not to. What does that say about us? Not much, you ask me. How am I supposed to trust her? How am I even supposed to be in a relationship with her if she won't let me in?
Sign of trouble.
It's a scratch, a claw, a ridge.
You're ready to run.
Please let me finish. I've decided I want more. I don't deserve more.
I agree.
So whatever happens, whatever you decide, Catherine Houghton, Beckett, will you marry me?
Oh my God. Oh my God, you're proposing.
Okay, you're surprised.
I thought you were breaking up with me.
I offering you a ring? So that's a yes?
No, wait.
No.
No.
So yes. Not yes?
No. Not yes.
You do know how this works, right?
So I love you. But this is my shot. Look, if this changes anything for you, if this changes the way that you feel...
Kate, I'm not proposing to you to keep you here. Or because I'm afraid I'm going to lose you. I'm proposing because I can't imagine my life without you.
Well, in that case, Richard Edgar Alexander Rogers Castle, yes.
I can't make it like it was before, can I?
Maybe it'll be better. This way, when we come home at the end of each day, we'll have something to talk about like normal couples. We're gonna make this work, I promise. Toxin. It was aerosolized. It was placed in the ventilation system of his car.
Was I? How bad?
Based on the amount found in your bloodstream, you have less than a day to live.
An antidote. There has to be an antidote.
The only existing vial was stolen with the toxin.
They can make more, right? They have to be able to make more.
It would take too long to synthesize.
How long?
A week.
It's too long.
Hey. We're going to find whoever's behind this. What we do, we're going to get that antidote, because I'm not letting you out of our engagement that easily. Maybe you could move it to another room.
The room?
When we
work a case together, this desk of yours is sort of kind of our space. And these elephants on parade have creeped me out since day one. So what do you say we just get rid of these? Oh, I'm sorry. Do you have a problem with that?
If you don't like the elephants, I don't like the elephants.
Okay, okay.
Seashells?
Well, not just seashells. Those are our seashells. We collected those
on our first walk in the Hamptons. Castle, you kept them.
We're both alphas, and it says that we need to define our shared territory together. These are pieces all over. These are all my stories, but the shells, that's our source.
I like our story.
Yeah.
What do you say about it?
I've never really been a baby person.
Want to have a baby?
I mean, some people see babies and they want to hold them, they want to nibble their toes, and I've never been one of those people. But I am sure I'll feel differently when we have one of our own.
Yeah, so this is a part of your plan to turn me into a baby person that's not working.
It isn't. Well, it was the first one.
Oh, it's working.
Yeah. You're a genius. Wipes. Lotion. Diaper. Lindsay.
I can't believe you marry her.
How did you know I married her?
One of your book jackets. You know, Richard Castle lives in New York with his wife, Senator Beck, and their three children.
Senator?
Three kids?
What?
Nothing.
When I volunteered to take Cosmo, I thought I was doing it for his benefit, but I realized I was doing it more for mine. When Alexis was little, I did it all on my own. And when you said you were a baby person...
Oh, okay. I get it. You were thinking...
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'll tell you what. When the time comes... There's no way I'm going to let you take care of our baby on your own.
How about we get hitched spring of next year?
What if I want to get married sooner?
Good point.
September. It's not too hot. It's not too cold. It's right in the Goldilocks zone. It's perfect.
It is, except I'll be out of town every weekend on my book signing tours. I keep making the mistake of thinking he's family, but he's not. You are. September. Married in September. It won't be too hot, it won't be too cold. It's in the Goldilocks zone, it's perfect.
Sweet Big Castle, what about your book tour?
Screw it. September.
Novelist Richard Castle and New York police detective Catherine Beckett, both native New Yorkers, are pleased to announce their engagement.
No. I didn't
do this.
Actually, I did.
I thought you...
I know, Castle. I like my privacy, but I do realize that you're somewhat famous. And if they are going to write about you, I want it to be the truth. I want it to be about Anna. Dear Rick, I don't know how much time I have even to write this letter. Babe, it's your letter. And I hope you never have to read this, that I can tell you all of these things in person. But if something happens and I don't make it, I need you to know that our partnership... Our relationship is the greatest thing that has ever happened to me. You're an amazing man, and I love you with all of my heart. Always.
See what happens when I leave you alone.
Babe, I wasn't alone. When they were interrogating me, the only thing that kept me going about our future, the wedding. You were with me the whole time.
Spring. Wow.
$100 deposit tonight, it's ours. So what do you say?
Just for a moment, I thought to myself, I don't know if I can do all of this without her. And that's why I said no about the venue. Do you know what else I wish you could experience?
Really?
Yeah, she would have loved you. You didn't get to go to your own prom?
And my date would have been Audra Dobson. So unbelievably hot.
Well, if it's any consolation, I missed my prom as well.
What?
Rebel Bex was a little too cool to go to a silly dance, so I went to a poetry slam at East Village instead. It's one of those seminal moments that I kind of wish I didn't skip out on.
Do the things we missed.
Do those we didn't.
Listen, I know you're a rebel and you hate convention, but Kate, would you go to the dance with me?
You regret it? A prank? Missing your prom, not being here with Audra Dobson?
Not even a little bit. Everything I've ever done, every choice I've ever made, every terrible, wonderful thing that's ever happened to me, led me to right here, this moment with you. Do we have a song? We must have a song.
I've
always loved the song. Could it be that we just found a song?
Oh, shut up. I can't sleep.
Let's put it into our vows. A promise to each other that even though we're married, it doesn't mean there is no more room.
I think we have to decide why we're actually having this wedding.
Well, for us.
Well, then why don't we just take a minute and write down the names of all the people that absolutely, positively have to be there, no matter what, to make us happy.
1 minute. True, but I figured it out.
Is Beckett with you?
Why was he alone?
Walker Simmons has been murdered.
I was there, but I didn't kill him. I thought about it, though.
Kate, you absolutely cannot tell anyone you were at that garage.
I know.
I found a bullet in Vulcan's body. Vulcan Simmons was killed with your gun.
You're being set up.
Listen, Castle, I can't ask you to stick around anymore.
You don't have to ask. I'm volunteering.
No, it's too dangerous.
Ours is a great love story. What's a great love story without obstacles to overcome? Every fairy tale has it. Terrible trials that only the worthy can transcend. Whatever happens, you can't give up. That's the deal. Just proud of you. Wherever she is, she's proud.
I never could have done this without you.
We want the happy ending. We can't give up.
That's why I want to marry you. It's almost here. You ready?
I've never been more ready. How about you?
How close are you?
I got our marriage license in my pocket. I will be there soon. Okay?
Yeah.
I love you.
I love you too. What about the wedding? Did he have any misgivings?
Misgivings? Thing from his mind, he couldn't wait to be married to you.
You don't
think he'd just walk away, do you?
No. I'm fine. I just never thought I'd see him again.
You've been missing for 2 months.
To say I owe you an apology seems an understatement.
I don't want an apology, Castle. I just want to understand.
Well, you know me, Kate. I wouldn't just leave. I am so sorry for everything I put you through. I can't remember. Though I do know I missed you terribly. Because there's no way I'm wrong. We'll get there. We'll find our way home. I can't imagine what it was like for you all those nights not knowing.
I was lucky. You came back.
I want you to know I never intended to leave you. Like this is. But just know that I love you. I've always loved you. Always.
I love you. And I'm here for you. I promise you, I'm not going anywhere.
The moment we met, my life became extraordinary.
The moment that I met you, my life became extraordinary. You taught me to be my best self, to look forward to tomorrow.
Here I stand before you.
I find a new challenge. It's kind of like when you kill Dr. Eric Storm because you're bored.
I am yours now. You taught me more about myself than I knew there was to learn.
And when I was vulnerable,
you were the joy in my heart. You're the last person I want to see every night when I close my eyes.
I love you, Richard Castle. And I want to love my life with your smile.
I got here.
Never seen another one.
We'll share and the strength of your embrace.
I love you, Catherine Beckett.
Yes, I promise you.
The mystery of you is the one I want to spend the rest of my life exploring.
Hey, why don't you just say something?
I didn't want you to think this.
I can feel your heartbeat.
Let's do it. Just you.
I promise you. I
promise to love you.
I'll be your friend.
To be your friend.
It's perfect.
Your partner in crime and life.
And your partner in crime and life.
I never am going to be guilty of leaving behind what matters.
You cannot leave behind those who have injured yourself until death do us part. And for the time for our lives.
Aren't you disappointed you're not going to be able to perform for an audience?
What audience I care about?
I make this vow to you.
To us. To the journey and to what lies ahead.
Out.
It's because I love you. There's a special ingredient I get this evening.
Really?
Well, now if I told you that, you might not need me anymore.
And don't tell me.
I fell in love with her because I've never met anyone like her.
I love you.
I love you. Rebecca makes me laugh. She challenges me. I became a better man.
You're all crazy for him. He's the love of my life.
This has been an epic year. Life's been full of joy and tears. Solving crimes and catching killers, just like Castle's famous thrillers.
Tell me where she is, Tyson. So help me, God. Last chance. Where is she?
Mr. Castle, let's just say for a moment that you and I did meet each other.
Where would that have been?
At my book party. You came to me, you asked me to consult on a copycat murder. It was 6 years ago, your hair was short then, it was adorable.
So you're a fan? And here I thought you didn't know me.
You know, you were right, we have met before.
We have? Yeah.
On a book tour for an old Derek Storm novel. I waited in line to get it signed. I used to love those books.
You never told me that. I have no need for genies. I already have everything I could ever wish for.
Right back at you, Anson.
I'm proud to have been his inspiration, and I am proud to be his wife.
I was 11 years old when I saw you. A figure clad in black. And that's when I saw a body.
Castle!
Whatever you decide, I'll look like a clay.
If it wasn't for him, where I would be, would we be?
Babe, we're not here because of him. We're here because of who we are. That's why you write mysteries. That's why I became a cop. We're both trying to bring justice to this world.
I just wanted to make a difference.
And you have. The question now is, can we make a bigger difference?
Do you think I can do it?
I know you can.
Regarding my relationship with Mr. Castle, he has proven to be a brilliant partner.
Well, whatever you decide, I will back you up.
And he's always had my back.
Only to go back and fall in love with you right now. 7 years ago, I thought I would never write again. And then you walked through the door. And my whole world changed.
Oh my God, this is so beautiful.
Happy anniversary.
Our wedding anniversary. You were right. You said I had no idea. But now I do. This is because of you. Because of us. Oh, well.
I have to be with you. No, I'm so here too.
Detectives in the NYPD, you just happen to end up shouting out. Must be fate.
You meet thousands of people, and none of them really touch you. And then you meet one person, and your life is changing.